Where did the good boys go to hide away?
What is your full name? Legal name is suggested, but you can do whatever you're comfortable with.
Luke Michael Baez.
And what is your relation to me?
I'd say you're an acquaintance. No, I'm kidding. Mallory is obviously one of my best friends in the world.
We should have been friends a lot sooner than we were.
Basically, Luke and I had a class together last year.
I cannot breathe.
Luke is feeling a little under the weather. When I mean under the weather, I mean kind of under the... And it is 4 p.m. on a Thursday.
And you know what?
Okay, Luke.
If you survived what I had to survive.
That's true. Luke,
you would be in that.
You are fresh off the plane. Fresh out the slammer.
Fresh out the slammer. Fresh out that bitch, Madrid. It was a good experience.
Really? Okay, tell me your favorite part of the semester. While you finish chewing, I'll tell them how we met. So we had a class together that was a requirement for our majors. I'm a political science major, and you are Clegg, no?
Correct.
What?
Correct.
Correct. Clegg stands for communications, law,
economics,
and government. And my major is political science, so kind of just the government piece. So we met in this like awful coding class, and I hated it. Luke hated it, but we didn't know each other. My friend, my roommate Eva, found him on Twitter under the username what? Should I say it?
Tipsy Gutter Girl.
Tipsy Gutter Girl. And we found you. I actually can't even say what the tweet was, but would stalk him and then go to class and be like, oh my gosh, there he is. We're obsessed with him. And then literally the last day of class. No, I DM'd you when I was like kind of under the weather on the metro. And I was like, I'm obsessed with you. And you were like, I'm obsessed with you.
Yeah, that was a lot.
That's not true. You're like, I watch your singing videos.
Because yeah, we were obsessed with each other. I think it was like a like the invisible string.
Isn't it just so, well, anyway, oh my God. I've written some questions for Luke. Oh, but you were going
to
tell
us. Like a cow to this.
That's not true. Sit back, relax with me. We have all the time in the world. So your favorite parts about your semester abroad?
Can I take one more time?
Hey, that's fine. Go right ahead.
I actually don't look that bad.
You look great.
I look hot. Okay, we're good.
Okay.
Interview. Like.
Well, what was your favorite part about your semester abroad in Madrid, Spain?
I think like having the independence to do really a lot, because it was like part like going on trips with our program, and it was like everyone in our program.
Oh.
Girl. And... Like, do you know how to interview? Like, you're giving, like, yeah, because we went on trips to the program and everyone was there, and that was, like, a lot.
Mm.
And so it was good to see those places because I would have never seen them, period.
Name some.
Okay, so in Spain, we went to Extremadura, north of Spain, like, Santiago de Compostela, Bilbao, Andalusia, Cordoba. You hear that?
Yeah, Cordoba.
Cordoba.
Yeah, period.
Sevilla.
Yeah.
I mean... Went to Toledo, Portugal, went to Lisbon and Porto. Yeah, it was fun.
Love that for you.
I want to have a reason to come back to Europe. Like, if I don't see everything I want to see, then I'll have to come back and see it at some point. So I did the things that I knew, like, if I never came back, I needed to see, and that was Paris, obviously, for the Olympics this summer.
Hi,
Simone Biles.
thank you for sharing, and I'm sure we'll get into...
I was not.
I'm cutting you off. Because, like, that you went.
Yeah, like, Paris...
Etc.
Croatia. To the
Croatia.
Homeland.
His homeland. What happened? Oh.
Dory and PK split.
Who is that?
Real Housewives of Beverly Hills.
Be serious.
Whose car? Dory?
Are you texting TMZ?
Yes. All my friends call me TMZ. Like, everyone calls me TMZ because I'm always... Like, I have my phone notifications are going off all day. And, like, I always see them. Like, I will read each one. Like... When it comes up. Because I always am in the know.
Oh, okay. So before we before you cancel yourself, where were you on January 6th, 2021? I'm serious. I'm not laughing. Okay, so I think we all know what that means.
It was January 6th, 2021. I remember where I was. I was in Madison, New Jersey. I was with my ex, and I was like, I need to, the Justin Bay in the Capitol, I need to go home and watch this. Went and picked up my sister from school, drove her home and watched it, and I think I posted on my HRH back in 2021.
His private story.
Yeah, I definitely posted, like, this is the war.
Definitely posted.
So that's where I was on January 6th. Unlike much people that do not think so, I was not at the Capitol.
Tennis game?
I needed her to win.
Well, she lost, so. Did you, like, have a bracket?
It was a whole, I'm not even getting into that.
Oh. Some of Luke's favorite things are tennis, the Olympics, reality TV, Twitter, offensive tea edits on YouTube, going viral on TikTok for making Steelers content, going to the Eras tour from a parking garage, and would you say you have other hobbies?
Big Brother HRH.
So that is one of my questions. Explain that for me.
Explain Big Brother HRH.
Yeah, explain how you, well, first of all, you can sign up if you are a member of his private story. And you can participate in a virtual Big Brother game, which I have won every time, I think.
I don't think that would be closer from the truth.
What do you think, like, what place have I gotten?
Okay, so Mallory got 39th place.
Out of kind of 40 out people.
41. During the Big Brother HRH season 4. However, in Big Brother HRH season 5, you made it pretty far.
Yeah, maybe like 17.
It was 17?
I don't know. It was something good.
Seventh.
No, babe.
Did you die during the gulag twist?
Yes. No. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. When that was
when
that like...
had to vote people in and you got voted in.
Yeah.
Honestly, Luke, there are people that I would be like, hey, who's this? And you're like, I don't know.
In Big Brother HRH?
Yes.
Lies. I knew everyone who was in it.
Okay. Until you didn't want to know them.
Well, yeah, some of them are banned.
Yeah, some of them are banned, and they will never be at a circus again. Oh, talk about... Okay, okay, okay. If you had to explain to someone what a circus is, let's start with textbook definition of circus. Redact your own name from it. What is a circus historically?
A circus is like a festival that like only happens once every like couple months or maybe once a year, mm-hmm. and it just circles on through, and when it comes everyone goes because it's like a whole show,
right?
So it's like, you know, it's, you never know what you're gonna get at a circus, like in the olden times, and like you're not gonna know what you get at the circus.
And then what would you say is what you now have hosted 3 times?
Yes.
The Luke Bias Circus. Paint that picture for us.
It's like Anna Wintour hosting the Met Gala. The most stressful experience of my entire life. It has been the best times, but it has to get there, I go through the worst of times.
Yeah, I completely agree. And as a participant for 2 circuses in a row now, I didn't know you for the first one, which pains me still to this day. I would say that I got very under the weather on the third one. Kind of for the first time in my life.
Wait. On the third?
On the third circus.
At Pan Am.
Correct.
Oh, yes.
Mallory had to be
escorted.
Evacuated.
Yeah. Out. There were security guards in the form of an Uber that my friends called for me. Good. And I had to kind of return to my home base, which is this space. Yeah.
Oh my God. I didn't know that.
They were with me.
The Uber driver came in.
No, no. Kind of dropped me off.
Okay.
And I tried to go to bed, and I woke up after a 2-hour nap and said, good morning, all. And they said, SNL hasn't started yet. And I was like, oh. So then I watched SNL still under the weather. But the circus is always the best day of... Well, it happens usually twice a year, yeah. Best 2 days of the year, and I swear to God.
Yeah, it's a good time. It depends on the vibes. I would say the first one had the best vibes. The third one had the second best vibes.
Really?
Yes, I felt a vibe.
Tell me about the themes of each of the circuses.
Each one has a very... That was right after the PR disaster. And so we were not in high spirits for that one.
The last theme of the circus was the Hunger Games, Panem. That was so incredible. I will insert photos of my friends and I who dressed up as different characters. I was... Mrs. Everdeen. My roommate was Mags. Eva was Wyrus.
Yes.
TikTok.
Yes, I made her be Wyrus.
My friend Ella came spontaneously for the circus from Philadelphia.
Rats mean snitch. Rats are the worst type of people you hang around with. So if I'm calling someone a rat and I mean it, that person is dead to me. Like, I will never speak nicely on them. I will never treat you with any respect. You're dirt under my feet. You sewer rat.
I agree. And I think growing up Christian has really brought us here.
Yes.
Forgiveness is everything, but not anymore.
Glory to God in the highest. May peace be on earth with everyone in this world.
Facts on God. That's what I would say when they say is
Christ. Me. Yes, he does. Jesus loves me, yes, he does. Okay,
how about this song?
I was raised in the church.
I can tell. Is there anyone... So we've talked about rats. What is the most insane lore that has happened to you at our university?
Like, physically or, like, drama-wise?
We'll first start with physically.
Physically, the TV case. In freshman year, when I got tuberculosis and had to go home for the rest of the fall semester, and then I couldn't drink in the spring.
I didn't know that. That's terrible. Yeah,
we survived it. So that's definitely my biggest physical lore. I always got my name in their mouth. For what? Like, fans. Like, literally fan behavior.
Yeah.
I think my new funniest lore, literally, I don't think this could be top. Because, like, you know, I've had people attack me. I've had people come for me, my name.
We had to switch to iPhone cam because my camera overheated. Luke is in costume. May I please try on the glasses? I have yet to do this.
I'm a collector of trinkets. Like, I love to have, like, small little Effie accessories. Trinket. Yeah. I like to have, like, accessories. Like, these are my, like, big fighting hoops. Like, if I have these, I just know something's going down.
Yeah.
And I love them, and I only wear them on special occasions. But I wanted to wear them for this. And then those glasses I got in Spain, they're my rave glasses. I'm wearing them to GovBall.
When is GovBall, by the way?
June 9th.
That's really soon. That's exciting. What was going on up there in your brain as a child in New Jersey?
Like, the same that it is now. There's one thing I said to all of them before I left in my junior year, because it was, and I said this to everyone, because at that point I was dating my boyfriend at the time. And he was very popular. I hate that term, but whatever. In his class, the senior class. And we were very close. And so, me being with him, I was everywhere. And so I made a lot of friends at that point. Everyone knew who I was. People would start saying, like, you know what? Like him or hate him, I will remember Luke Baez till the day I die after I graduate high school. And that was like...
Wow.
And then I started saying that to everyone. Because I was like, you know what? And then I turned it back to them and I was like, you know what? Like me or hate me, you're going to remember me.
Wow, Luke. That's an impact.
I stood on business.
Period.
You know what? I don't play with that. Like, I literally would tell my sister, like, if anyone DMs you, if anyone messages you, if anyone plays on you, I will get their ass.
And did.
Like, I don't care.
I just love that you so fiercely defend your friends and the people that matter to you. And you also stick up for yourself in a way that's like, I think some people would see like beef as a negative thing, and it's not, because
you stick up for what's right, and I think I can take notes from being honest. Like, I'm not honest.
I think everyone should take notes about being honest. I feel like being honest to people that you love, for me, is the number one.
Tell me about, what award did you win recently?
Damn award. I won municipal. I won intern of the year for the municipal government of New Jersey.
Like, that's a big deal.
For the entire state.
That's a big deal.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
There was a ceremony, a speech.
There was a ceremony, a speech. I gave a speech. I said words.
The mayor talked to me.
Mayor, everyone of power.
Pop culture. Who are your top three favorite artists?
Tyler the Creator.
Fred Again.
Yeah,
Fred Again. And Laundry Day.
That's a really good three.
Yeah. What do you think about Eternal Sunshine?
I really like
me
it.
Me too. Help me feel alive when you're in there.
And so...
Wait.
We can't be friends. You're wrong.
You are, bitch.
It's, I don't want to play pretend. Hits you over the head, hits you over the head, and says, wake up.
Now we pray our separate scenes.
Do you know what another song that I really like is?
Oh yeah. Whatever goes around eventually
comes back to you. Graduation.
He's throwing on the stage.
Can we do
the
SPA
that
version? If it's Friday at 1:30. Wait, we're done? I have a segment.
Wait, okay.
We're not done? Do you know? Oh, do you know my phone password? You don't know it?
Do you know mine?
Yes, I think so. I came out to my mom and dad in a very inconspicuous manner, and they did not take it seriously, which will be important later. My mom said that it was a decision that was made too early, and I should rethink it in a couple of months. And my dad...
Coming out or being gay?
Being gay.
Okay.
And my dad basically didn't acknowledge it. He was like, whatever. A year and a half passed by, and a lot of bad things were going on at school. At school and at home. Very toxic environment. It's not anymore, thank God. It can be, but it's not as bad. It came to a point where my parents had to talk to the school, and my advisor, who was a lesbian woman, outed me to my parents. I wasn't even there at the meeting. I couldn't even tell them. So my school outed me out. Yeah, so that's when I unofficially came out. It was like Halloween 2019. Officially.
Cause
I'm, yeah, mess. Because they thought it was a problem. They were like, did you know that Luke was gay?
I'm glad that you still, like, commemorate the day that you came
out. Of course.
It's a big deal.
I'm gonna give Mallory her present.
Oh my goodness! Thank you!
So, first... Is, oh, my wallet's in here. You can get my wallet.
Thank you!
This is pretty.
Oh, it's so pretty. Thank you. Where'd you get it?
The Rostro.
What's that?
It's like this big thrift market in Madrid.
Thank you.
And then I got you some
postcards. Oh, I'm gonna put them on my wall. You know I will. Wow. Oh, you wrote on them.
Yes.
You're a disaster. This one says, you're a disaster. Kill Kim Connor, burn the sternio of triplets. Other than that, you're pretty cool. Can't wait for the interview. Expect disaster. I love you. Thank you for always going with my bits and letting me be. I could never. I love you so much.
Love you.
Look, guys.
And this is a tote bag.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, I love it. Okay, tell me about this.
So this is a Rostro, the big... authentic marker.
Oh my god, thank you!
Bye! Bye.